The law of conservation of mass states that matter cannot be created or destroyed. This is especially true when it comes to chemical reactions. When we write chemical formulas for reactions, it's not enough just to know and write the atomic symbols and form an equation out of them. You must observe the law of conservation of mass even when writing out a chemical equation. So how do we do this? In chemical equations, we must have the exact same number of each element on both the product and reactant side. Unfortunately, we cannot change the subscripts of individual compounds without changing the compound as a whole. So the only way we can affect a chemical equation and change the quantity of reactants and products is by changing the coefficient. We can change the coefficient in the front of the element of a compound as many times as we want. Once the equation has the same amount of each element, then reactant and product, we can say the equation is balanced. When starting out a balanced equation, I feel that it's easier to create a chart so that you can document how many of each type of element there is on both the product and reactant side. After writing an unbalanced or initial chemical equation, I will separate my reactant and products by physically drawing a line through the yield sign. I will then make my first column on both sides of the atomic symbol for each element present in the equation. I would then create a second column that accounts for the subscripts of each element. If there is no subscript after an element, we can safely assume that there is an understood one there. The third part of the chart is where we're going to put our coefficients, and we will do that in a bit. The final column on both sides is the total number of that specific atom. We find this number by multiplying our subscripts and coefficients together. Now that we got our chart set up, we can start plugging in coefficients and balancing chemical equations. The only time we plug in coefficients is when there is an element of the product and reactant side that are not equal to each other. When this happens, I usually start with the side that has the least amount of that particular element. Then I look for the differences between the two sides and figure out what I need to multiply one or even both sides by in order to make them equal. Once I get both sides equal, I can then write the coefficient into the formula. Note, the coefficient can only go in front of an element or compound. It cannot go within the middle of a compound or at the end of it. Because of this, if you put a coefficient in the front of a compound, it is going to affect all the elements within that compound. This means you may have to adjust some stuff on your chart. You will continue plugging in coefficients into the equations until all the elements on both product and reactant sides are equal. Once this happens, you have successfully balanced the equation. So for this equation, we are going to talk about the synthesis of aluminum chloride. This is going to be aluminum Al plus chlorine, Cl2, is going to give you aluminum chloride, AlCl3. So my first step after writing an unbalanced equation is to draw out my chart. In this first column of both reactant and product sides, I have listed all the elements within the equation. In this case, I only have aluminum and chlorine on both sides. My next step is to account for the subscripts. For aluminum on both the product and reactant side, there is no subscripts. So we can assume that that is a 1 here. Where this equation gets interesting is with the chlorine atoms. In the reactant side, we have a 2 as a subscript, and on the product side, we have a 3. Since we have put no coefficients in yet, we can go ahead and get our totals. After multiplying our subscripts by our coefficients, we see that aluminum on both sides have a total of 1. So far so good, they're equaled out. Now, we can go look at our chlorine atoms. By filling out the chart, we can quickly see that we have a different number of chlorine atoms on both sides of the equations. Because of this, we are going to have to add a coefficient to them. Out of the two sides, the reactant side has less chlorine than the product side. Because of this, we're going to start here. I look at each side of the reaction and realize in order for these elements to equal one another, they're going to have a total of 6 on each side. In order to do this, I must first add a coefficient of 3 to my reactant side and a coefficient of 2 to my product side. After doing this, I multiply them together and I get 6 chlorine atoms on each side. This is all good, but the issue arises when I add my 2 to the coefficient of my aluminum chloride. The coefficient not only affects the chlorine, but also affects the aluminum on that side. Now, I can see that I have a total of 2 aluminums on my product side and 1 on my reactant side. In order to balance this equation, I'm going to have to add a coefficient to my aluminum on the reactant side. Once I add a 2 to this, it makes it so that I have 2 aluminums on both sides of the equation. Now I make sure that both sides are equal with every element, and after that I can write my balanced equation. Here's you a helpful hint. When balancing chemical equations, start by balancing your metals first. Then move to your nonmetals and leave any oxygen or hydrogen atoms till the very end. It will save you a lot of time erasing and redoing things. I hope this video helped you out in balancing equations. If you're still not feeling confident in balancing chemical equations, then feel free to reference another one of my videos where I can work through balancing several chemical equations. Like always, keep up the good work. Thank you for watching this all the way to the end. Don't forget to hit that like or subscribe button if you haven't already. If you're one of my students or just want to watch related videos to this topic, click the playlist button on the right side of this screen. If you're just wanting to keep up with this channel, my latest video is going to be posted to the left of the screen. Once again, hey, thank you for supporting this channel. Thank you for supporting me, and good luck this year in your classroom.